Number 55 is important to me on the football field, as other players around the league know. But 55 is important to everyone off the field. If people observe the speed limit and buckle their safety belts, there will be fewer accidents and injuries. You should also keep the right amount of air in your tires. Check them every few weeks. Driving can be fun and safe if you do it like the pros. For more information and a free NFL schedule, write Safe Driving, Box 1801, Washington, D.C.
Height, 5'11" in his stockings. Weight, 178 stripped, about 190 in football togs. Underneath was a full-blooded Sac and Fox Indian. Jim Thorpe, the legend. Winner of the Olympic decathlon, he became one of our first professional football players. He played with guys like Nasty Nash and Fats Henry and inspired the young pro league. Football has many legends, and they're all here waiting for you at the Pro Football Hall of Fame in Canton, Ohio. Don't miss it.
The preceding announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Football League. The score here at the half at RFK Stadium in Washington is the Redskins 20 and the Philadelphia Eagles 10. I'm Don Crickey with Sonny Jurgensen. A spectacular play just before the end of the half, almost resulting in another Washington touchdown.
Yes, right before the half, the last play of the half, Theismann back, threw the ball. Watch the adjustment that Gene Fugit makes on the football. The Eagles back guarding against a long touchdown. You see the safety Sanders coming over. Fugit breaks a tackle right here, runs the ball down to about the 4-yard line before getting hit as time runs out. But watch Gene Fugit call timeout on the ground. He's calling time right here. Give me a timeout. Time had expired, and great play by the Redskins. Only, unfortunately for them, they didn't have time to get one more play off.
Well, the play started with just 7 seconds left in the second quarter, and it ran down while he was running that pattern. Theismann has been very interesting at quarterback in this game. He's done a pretty good job, a very good job.
He has done exactly what George Allen wanted him to do, and that is generate offense. He came in, he's been running around, running sprint outs and so forth in the first half. He was 11 out of 23 for 207 yards. A good half of throwing for him. He had a couple of touchdowns called back in one of his drives. But you look at the stats here, the turnover is the big thing. Two turnovers for Philadelphia, no turnovers for Washington. Yeah. No mistakes, only one penalty by Washington. Big thing, and even the time of possession there. Philadelphia, even though they've had the ball, they've given it up, and then they had that short 16-yard punt by Spike Jones. And throughout the first half, the Redskins enjoyed excellent field position, never deeper than their own 45 to start from, and boy, you can play from there.
The Philadelphia Eagles, there's George Allen now. George got to feel pretty good. His team has not, as you pointed out, Sonny, generated a lot of offense throughout this season so far, scoring only 8 touchdowns in the first 6 games. The biggest production was 24 points against the St. Louis Cardinals, the game they won 24-14, but scored just 17 against the Giants, 10 against Atlanta, 10 against Tampa Bay, 16 against Dallas, only 6 against the Giants last week. So changing pitchers has helped them, at least this week.
It has, and that's what they wanted. He gives that mobility. He throws the ball a little quicker than Billy. He moves around a lot more than Billy. But, you know, you go back, not to defend Billy Kilmer and get into any kind of controversy over Kilmer and Theismann, because
Kilmer's been great for this team for a long time.
He certainly has, but they have made big plays today that they haven't been making throughout the early part of this season.
Now, Horst Gilman sidewinds into the football and drills it down the field. And here comes Eddie Brown from the 7. 25 and out to the 28-yard line. And Washington goes in offense there, first and 10.
I'm sure that Joe Theismann saying, wait a minute, what are we doing back here inside of our 30?
One of the great things, honey, on a special team is after the play's over, you see two guys who are matched up against each other still wrestling and bumping each other, oblivious to where the ball is or who's got it.
That's right.
Osborne was just wrapping heads there. Osborne of the Eagles against Joe Harris, young linebacker from the Skins.
34!
First and 10 for Theismann and the Redskins. They lead the game 20-10 as we open the third quarter from scrimmage. Thomas with a pitch back. Johnny Outlaw, number 20, came up from the left corner to make the hit.
New England's leading the Jets 17-10. Grogan hits Stan Morgan. for the 52-yard pass.
Thomas has now run the ball 11 times, has gained 38 yards. Here comes Frank Grant out wide to the right. And Danny Buggs goes out wide to the left on second and 10 for the Redskins. 395. Big rush. Theismann has a man open. Thomas catches the ball and takes the quick hit from Herman Edwards, the right corner. At about five on the play.
Dangerous though then, John, because he threw into the zone. It rotated that way. Herman Edwards had come up. Sanders had gone deep on that side, and that's a little dangerous because you throw and you don't realize that man's coming up. A lot can happen to the football.
Frank Grant now comes wide to the right, and Buggs goes to the left. Setbacks are Clarence Harmon and Calvin Hill. They go to Harmon, right in his way. Ooh, there was a stand-up hit. He got the good slug put on him there. Coming up to hit him was Lem Burnham.
Take a look at this draw play. You see Johnson going to the right on Hoss, who makes a good block on him, turns around. Mihalik and Berge both miss a tackle. Good, strong running in there.
I think that isn't a hit by Lem Burnham.
Oh, Burnham. Burnham was here for a while. He was with the Redskins for a short stay. Big man, 6'4", 240.
So the carry comes up just short of the first down. It brings up fourth and one, and there is Larry Marshall back for the Eagles. Mike Bragg, a punt for the Redskins. Bragg is not a deep punter, but his are very hard to return. Oh, that looks like they almost got the ball in the end zone there. Osborne coming up on the play. Here comes Marshall. Looking for that gap and trying to accelerate through it. 44-yard punt by Mike Bragg, and so the Eagles go on offense for the first time in the second half. We have 12:50 to play in the third quarter. The score remains the Skins 20, the Eagles 10.
Introducing the Ford in your future, the new Ford Fairmont wagon, a new wagon designed for today and the years ahead. The Fairmont wagon has excellent mileage ratings, but while it is trim and lean outside, Fairmont has almost 90% of the passenger space of most large wagons, and with a seat down can swallow up all this cargo. Yet for all this, the new Fairmont wagon, as shown, is actually sticker price less than this little VW Rabbit. Test drive Fairmont, the newest better idea from the wagon master.
This fresh egg is going to help us sell this brand new Freeflex shoe from Freeman. Watch. You can do it with any new Freeman Freeflex. Let's use the same egg.
Tomorrow night at 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 Central and Mountain Time on CBS, it's Logan's Run, and Jessica falls into the hands of a society that can split human beings into two creatures. One good, the other evil. That's tomorrow night on Logan's Run here on CBS. We have 12:50 to play in the third quarter. The Redskins holding the 20-10 lead they had at half. The Eagles with the ball, their first possession of the third quarter. They have it at their 27-yard line. Rusty Tillman now shaken up and is on the sidelines being attended to. Oh, he's going back in at middle linebacker. It is McClinton who's come off.
Yeah, I think it looks like something's wrong with his hand or his wrist. He's going back in now. They were just hitting a little tape. Rusty said, come on, let me play one play. Look at him. Yeah.
He's had some there. Big plays in special teams, though.
Oh, hasn't he?
Lavender and Williams at the corners now. Looking to defend against Jaworski's long passes.
Watch this play.
Great play by McDowell.
McClinton on a blitz. Right in the hole. McDowell underneath. McClinton. A lot of people in. Dennis Johnson. Oh, he's hurting again.
Apparently he banged up pretty good. So now Tillman's coming back out. It was a loss on the play of about a yard and a half. It'll be second and about 11.
He came right in and blitzed. And he took a shot there. Boy, he hates to come out of that football game, I can tell you that.
He's the guy that said before this one, we won't need any speeches, we don't need any motivation. We know what's on the line right now. We lose this one, it could be our season.
Well, it is for them to have an opportunity to make the wild card berth, and it's too early to talk about playoffs because the season's got a long way to go. A lot of things can happen to a lot of key people.
Jaworski takes a deep drop, puts it up.
Ooh.
Smith was leaning to the outside, and the ball came in very close to Joe Lavender. So the clock is stopped, 11:54 to play in the third quarter, and third and long is now coming up for the Eagles.
Situation they want to avoid, the nickel defense, Eddie Brown coming in for Rusty Tillman. They'll go into the nickel, and they try to confuse you in this, and with good pass rush, and they can bring that extra linebacker at times. Difficult situation to try to throw into. You see Dr. Stan Levine looking over Harold McClinton there.
Herb Lusk goes quickly in motion to the right. Jaworski is sacked and dropped to the 23. The Redskins break down the pocket and knock down the quarterback. Second sack of the day for the Redskin defense. Dennis Johnson, 61, was the first guy on him.
They had three people in, Don, covering Charlie Smith. They were trying to go long to him. That's why he had to pull the ball down and run it back through the middle.
There is Fast Eddie Brown.
Fast Eddie.
Spike Jones into punt now, number six for the Eagles. Standing just inside his 10. Gave it a ride. Eddie Brown signals for and makes the fair catch at the 37-yard line of the Skins, a 40-yard punt. Washington goes back on offense, first and 10. So the Redskins punt return unit comes off, and Joe Theismann of the offense goes out protecting their 10-point lead they have at the half.
Sir.
It's about time you're here. Another late night, I presume? Well, let's get started. The first thing we have for your assignment is this microcassette tape recorder.
Genius. Did you design this, huh?
No. Actually, it's a Sony. Next is this radio with 32 worldwide bands. Can tune in just about any place.
Extraordinary. Who gets the credit for this one?
This is a Sony, too. You'll also need this ultra-compact portable video camera, and we're going to mount this 5-inch color TV in your car, along with this Betamax deck for playback.
Remarkable. Are they,
Yes. They're Sony also.
Excuse me, sir, but did you just walk into a store and buy these?
Well, yeah.
Well, keep up the good work, sir.
If it's a little extraordinary, chances are it's a Sony.
Monday, Logan, Jessica, and Rem are captured by a society with an amazing secret. Behold the terror the future holds. Logan's Run, Monday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
There's your pal, Coach Allen. What do you think he's saying there?
They're going over some defensive adjustments there in the coverage, I imagine.
Theismann goes to the run. Mike Thomas is stopped and then knocked down. Bunning, shooting the gap, got a piece of him. Also on the play, initially was Manny Sistrunk, and then Frank LeMaster made the tackle.
Dallas leading Detroit now 13-0. Their last score came on a 15-yard pass from Staubach to Billy Joe Dupree.
Dallas is like an automobile. They go as fast as they have to every week.
Henry still got him. It's 10-10 in the second. Now in the third period, I think.
Second down and 10 coming up for the Redskins. Their 38-yard line. Theismann dumps it off. And it falls dead at the 40-yard line, so it's going to be third down and 10.
Good rush again by Burnham. Burnham got in there and put the rush on him, and I think he may have gotten a piece of it.
Bunning out of North Carolina in his sixth year is a good blitzing linebacker. He comes on a lot of passing downs on the weak side.
The word on Harold McClinton is that he has a pinched nerve in his right shoulder. Not sure whether he'll be back later or not.
Chris Hamburger on the sidelines in street clothes, bad knee. Charlie Taylor out of this game, hamstring pull. John Riggins out with a knee. Theismann looking deep on third and 10. He takes time and pumps it up, and look at Mike Thomas catch the ball. He got it and he held on. Theismann had the time, and then he put it right between the double twos.
Watch your time Joe Theismann has here. He stays in his pocket, which is something he's worked on, and look at him wait. Look at him wait, reloads, and then throws the ball. Mike Thomas alone on the sidelines gets knocked out of bounds. It's good for 22 yards and a first down.
Herman Edwards really nailed him, but Mike Thomas held on, so the Redskins on a third and 10 get the big play, and now they have the ball at the 39-yard line of Philadelphia. Clarence Harmon gets the run inside the 35-yard line. LeMaster knocked him down there along with Sistrunk.
Good block that time by Terry Hermeling on Bill Berge.
Well, that completion to Thomas was a big play because they would have punted the ball back and Eagles would have got fairly good field position.
It was, and it's something you have to give an awful lot of credit. An excellent throw, but give a lot of credit to that offensive line protecting the quarterback.
They really took care of it. Pass blocking is tightened up considerably this week. Theismann dropping. He has time again. Lets her go long, and the man is wide open. It is a touchdown for Danny Buggs. Nope, he stepped out of bounds. He stepped out of bounds. We'll see if they really stepped out after he caught it or he caught it out.
You see the play action going back. He runs it out and up pattern. Good protection again. The throw, excellent throw. You see the official right there marking on the left of your screen. He marked it before the ball was even completed.
I think he went out of bounds and came back in, stepped up.
That was the reason he went out of bounds and came back in. Not allowed to do that. You know, and that's something he might pass off his little experience, too. Danny Buggs is under.
Five, the swing pass is caroms off the hands of Calvin Hill. Here comes Mosley, Sonny, once again.
I tell you, what's he got, two today? He had three last week.
Let me keep those 50-yarders, you see. Remember he had that 50-yarder they called back because they got the penalty and had a first down.
I've never seen him kick with more confidence than he's kicking with right now, and he just feels like every time he walks out there, he's going to drill it home. New England leading the Jets now 24-10.
New England's got a machine. They got it working. Pretty good. Mosley is into the ball, a 51-yard attempt. He got it. Boy, is he playing football for the Redskins. So the Redskins come out and salute Mark Mosley, and he well deserves it as he now has put the Redskins out in front 23-10.
Want to cut your fuel bills? Whether your house is new or old, put insulation everywhere it can save you money. Your attic, you need a 6 to 12 inch blanket of pink Owens Corning fiberglass. Walls, full insulation. Unheated crawl space, insulate below the floor. Live where it's cold, insulate basement walls. See your Owens Corning fiberglass supplier to learn all about insulation. Insulation is cheaper than oil.
You got a place to get to. Exxon knows along the way. It's nice to hear somebody say, thanks for coming by today. Exxon wants you here tomorrow. It's always nice to say, come on in, hey, where you been? Thanks for coming by today.
Thanks for coming by.
There's that New England Jets score, Sonny.
Yeah, Grogan hit Hasselbeck with a 4-yard pass.
Mosley, who was originally drafted by the Philadelphia Eagles back in 1970 in the 14th round, kicks it off for the Redskins after hitting the long field goal. Here comes Larry Marshall for Philadelphia. Out across the 25 to the 26. And now trailing by 13 with 9:40 left to play in the third quarter, Jaworski brings the Eagles offense out. Mosley spent 70 with Philadelphia, then went to Houston for 2 years, now in his fourth year with the Redskins. Scored 97 points last year.
You've never seen anybody work harder in training camp than Mark Mosley. He doesn't participate in all the hitting drills, but a man that works on his own by himself all the time, and probably harder than anybody up there.
Last season, he held opponents to a 16-yard average on kickoff returns. That's the second lowest in NFL history. Those high kickoffs. Patterson has a lot of people hitting on him.
Ooh, are they swarming now?
Houston came up.
This has been the mark. Minnesota and Atlanta still tied up in the fourth period. This has been the mark of the Redskin defensive team, and since George Allen has been here, when they get people down, they like to keep them down.
That Atlanta's tough to score on.
For everyone, too.
Here comes Jaworski now with a second and 10. His team down 23 to 10 in the third quarter. Blitz is on, and Ron McDowell is the man who pops through.
The Dancing Bear.
The back had a pull out and hit Dusek, 59, and that left McDowell a free lane.
This is what they like there. When they're down, they know people have got to put it upstairs, and they don't have to worry about the run. They can just tee off and come. You know why he hesitated right then at the end? He wanted to make sure they found out when the film is on them on Tuesday. He wants to make sure they found out who got that sack.
Hoses get that 79 in from every angle.
San Diego leading Miami.
Wow, fourth quarter now.
Ooh, 7-6 still.
San Diego's got a lot of offensive players.
They can hurt you in a hurry, but looks like a defensive struggle today.
So now third and long, long yardage. Third and 20 for the Eagles and Jaworski. On the run, the ball was broken up. Carmichael went for it. Joe Lavender made a big defense. He intercepted the ball.
What a play.
Had his hands on the ball inbounds.
What a great play by Joe Lavender. You see him, he goes back, can't find anybody. Curtis was coming from his left side. He rolls out. You see him chasing right there, but look at this interception. How does he get this ball? It looks like Carmichael gets it, and Lavender comes away with it.
So now the Redskins forcing yet another turnover. Have the ball first and 10 at the 46-yard line of Philadelphia. Third quarter, Washington leads 23-10. Heisman eludes the rush. That's a rip. There's a penalty marker down at the 25-yard line. Frank Grant thinks it's pass interference. Holding against the Eagles, so it'll be a first down for the Redskins.
Joe, having gone long a couple of times now, once to Grant and also to Bugs, and he hit Bugs a couple of times. It didn't count, but he came right out after that turnover, trying to put the Eagles away for good with a home run. Automatic first down.
Holding, number 20, defense, first down.
I think you're better off holding there than pass interference.
Right.
5 yards is better than
better hold and letting him beat you that deep if he was going by him. First and 10 for the Redskins. Now at the 41-yard line of the Eagles. Pretty close in first downs. 14 to 10, the Redskins with the 4 advantage. Here comes Mike Thomas turning upfield inside the 40 and down to the 35. John Bunning was across to hit him. Logan was there. Carl Hairston was also on the play.
5 tough yards in. Boy, it makes you game with this good field position. Again, starting in plus territory. This is the third time, and once at the 50, 4 times right at the 50-yard line, once way down inside. So it really makes a difference in your play calling.
Hey, the Redskins, for all their injuries and problems, certainly look good.
They have
together.
Inspired football game, and we said coming into the thing, George has never lost 3 in a row since he's been here, and they wanted this one badly. They realized the importance of the game, but so did the Philadelphia Eagles.
In fact, no George Allen coach team has ever lost 3 in a row. For Allen's, under George Allen, the Redskins are 80% plus in wins here at RFK Stadium, and they are 82% over the Philadelphia Eagles during George Allen's career. 11-2-1.
11-2-1.
Third and three, and there is Theismann swinging it out to Calvin Hill for a first down. Bunning misses him. Blockers are out there, and Calvin Hill at 6'4", 235 pounds, crashes his way down inside the 15 down to the 10, but there's a penalty marker back at the line of scrimmage.
See what this is going to be. It's going to be another holding call. Boy, something that really plagues and has plagued the Redskins. Today, even though they're leading this football game, it has plagued them again. Let's see who it is. I think, yes, he did. He caught Ron Saul. And a little check over pattern by Calvin Hill. And a good piece of blocking. Look at the downfield blocking.
64 offense.
Yes, Ron Saul. Good blocking. Good hustle downfield by Len Hoss. And another big play is nullified.
They got enough assistant coaches on the Redskins to field a team. 11.
You want to hear something? New Orleans, 17. Los Angeles, 10. Three-yard pass. Three-yard pass and Blanchard. They must have faked a field goal. He couldn't be punting that close.
That's right. He's the hole. Here is Theismann rolling out.
There's another flag down.
There's a man open, too. Danny Bugs. Oh, he could not hold on.
And a flag down again also.
Apparently the moving pocket is grabbing a little as it moves.
Let's see what we get again.
This one offside against the Eagles.
Well, I'll get another shot at it.
Yep. That was a...
Let's look at it again. Sounds redundant to say it, but look at the mobility.
They're double-teaming up on that Charlie Johnson.
Goes in a little crowd, does
offside,
a little reverse and comes
78,
out.
Defense, third down again.
Runs wide left, waving, throws it off balance. And Bugs almost comes away with it. Oops, he shied away right there at the end.
I think
to avoid the contact right there. But if he had come up with that, he could have made a touchdown. The one chance he has to make a touchdown, they're not going to call it against him, huh?
Another shot before too long. Theismann's looking at him deep. Eye puts it up short. Gets Calvin Hill. Penalty marker is down again in the Redskin backfield. So he looks like might have a hold.
Yes, we do. Another holding call.
Play comes back. Oh, they're quick to jump on the Redskins here. That look at the scoreboard. It's 23-10.
I think it's going to be on George Stark this time. I saw him talking with the official. Let's see who he comes up with. The right tackle, number 74, George Stark. 64 they caught last time. If he don't...
Holding, 74, offense, third down.
George Stark.
Crowd really gets on the holding calls here, don't they?
Yes, they do. You see what's happening. And this is the thing, it's hurt him, but of course getting that big start at the beginning of the game, you can imagine what this does to your football team in a crucial game when you keep making mistakes like that, getting shoved back.
Wide to the left. Third and long, long yardage. Theismann gets it away. Going for the football is Frank Grant. Intercepted. Johnny Outlaw intercepted the ball. He's coming right back in a hurry. He can play football with the ball. Johnny Outlaw takes it all the way back to the 40.
And I'm telling you.
Hey, that was a play.
A heck of a play by Johnny Outlaw.
Your pal Len Hoss finally got him.
Yes, but I'm telling you. You can't blame Joe Theismann. He makes a good throw under pressure. He puts the ball out. Just an excellent play there. But Joe Theismann got forced into this situation because of the holding calls on the offensive line.
Andy Logan leads the blocking.
Here's two good friends. Tonight is kind of special.
Tomorrow we go back to civilization.
Let's have a last night in the wilderness party.
Yes. Great idea.
I've got just what we need.
So tonight.
Hey. Hello, LeBron. You've been hiding that all week.
I was waiting for the right moment.
When you want the taste of a truly great beer, tonight, let it be Lowenbrau.
Well, like the song says, here's to good friends.
With the price of most things going up, the sticker price of Pinto, the best-selling American small car, is coming down. As of October 3rd, new 78 model Pintos with more standard features will have a lower sticker price than last year's model comparably equipped. Important features are now standard, like AM radio, power front disc brakes, rear window defroster, tinted glass, and protective body side moldings. Ford Pinto, more car for the money than last year. When America needs a better idea, Ford puts it on wheels.
Joe Theismann has put the ball in the air 29 times already today. Has hit 13 for 195 yards, two touchdowns. Just was picked off by Johnny Outlaw. Now Jaworski comes right back, puts it up, and woo, a free football that Jake Scott had a play on. Went off Carmichael.
He really hummed that one, and he had it a little high for Carmichael and only got one hand up on it. That's Washington's first turnover today.
Jaworski's had some problems, hasn't he, Sonny, with that bad thumb?
Obvious that it's bothering him.
2 for 14 for 35 yards throwing. He got a concussion and a broken thumb on one play before the half and was right back in there. Quick screen out to Carmichael. Good execution by the Eagles, and the big guy rips it up. Gets a first down inside the 40. Boy, they set those blockers and gave the big 6 foot 8 inch wide receiver room to go. Curtis finally got him.
Good play. They've had a lot of success with this in the past. Tough throw for the quarterback to do a complete spin to throw that ball. But look at Wallace out there blocking. And those strides, he covers about 4 yards a stride. And he covered them very quickly then. He takes it down to the 36 yard line.
That took him about 6 strides then. He got 25 yards.
New England leading the Jets now, 24-13 in the fourth period.
And we see McClinton now is going back into the game. So the middle linebacker replacing Tillman. Eagles starting them on the drive. They trail 23-10 in the third quarter. 5:25 to play in. Jaworski sets himself, swings it out this time. Tom Sullivan gets the ball and looks for that gap and shoots into it. Got about 4.
A lot of people around the football. Gerard Williams, Jake Scott, and
Brad
also
Dusick.
Brad Dusick out there.
Remember that game last year, the Monday night game, the Eagles, the Redskins playing at Philadelphia, and ball hit somebody on the helmet. Or Dusick hit a ball with his helmet and popped it free and ran it in for a touchdown just before the half. Redskins went on to win 20-17.
Second and 6. Eagles need some points in this drive to get back in the football game.
We're at the 33. Up, Dennis Johnson gets all around Jaworski.
That's their third sack of the afternoon, their fourth sack, I understand. Here you see, going back, good coverage in the secondary that time. Johnson just beat his man to the inside. He beat Stan Walters and came in there and made the play. Look at that. They won't go down, will they?
Cincinnati holding into a touchdown lead over Houston in the fourth quarter at Cincinnati. We have 4:15 left to play in the third quarter here at RFK Stadium in Washington. Eagles now set back to the Redskins 41. Third and almost 15. Jaworski pumps it. Did not have a good grip on the ball and skipped it in.
You're right, Don. He just threw it real short then. The pressure was coming on the outside of him, and he had to throw it short. I think it's more than he'd like to admit. That finger's got to be bothering him some.
It is a perfect football day here in the nation's capital. Temperature about 60 degrees, cloudless, sunny skies. The Eagles having problems on third downs, converting them.
Yes, 1 out of 8 now.
Spike Jones intently waits for the snap. Puts it up real high. Eddie Brown's got a fair catch. Twice Eddie's had a fair catch. He doesn't like to do that. Sometimes discretion. better part. On Our Own, tonight right after Rhoda, here on CBS at 7:30 Central and Mountain Time, 8:30 Eastern Time. Every family has its differences, but where do you watch the Boninos battle tonight? This edition of On Our Own. This is the first time, I think, Sonny, the Redskins have been back up this far to take over the ball.
It is their worst possession back on the 13-yard line.
They opened the game with two quick touchdowns the first two times they got it. The 43 and the 29-yard lines of Philadelphia. Thomas turning out. Randy Logan came across. Lots of Eagles on the tackle. Pete Lazatich playing the nose tackle was also on the stop.
Dallas still rolling, Don. 20 to nothing over Detroit in the second period. Their last score was a 19-yard pass from Roger Staubach to Scott Laidlaw. Like they're going to win that seventh in a row for the first time.
Jimmy the Greek says it's 6-1 that Dallas will be in the Super Bowl. Down they go. It was almost intercepted. Then it was caught. Herman Edwards had a play on the ball, but it skipped through his hands, and Danny Buggs caught it for a 15-yard gain.
You're talking about making a big play, and what a one that could have turned the other way. Right. Look at this pass. Good protection, and it goes right through. Out. Is that, who is that? That's Herman Edwards, has a great play on it, but doesn't come up with a potato. And Danny Buggs makes a great catch. Oh, he had a shot at intercepting that one, didn't he?
The Redskins have really tightened up their pass blocking this game. There was 14 sacks of Redskin quarterbacks in the last two games coming into today. Theismann takes a look. That's her look. Timing pattern. Penalty marker down as Fugit goes for the football.
Tell you something about that pattern, Don. That was an adjustment on the part of Gene Fugit. He went up on his own when he saw they got a holding call again. He makes this adjustment himself. Watch him at the bottom of your screen, number 84 coming out. He's running a little short out pattern, but watch it as he goes out, as Joe is looking for him, is looking back, and as he holds the ball,
holding number 20,
he goes up
defense,
the field.
Automatic first down.
And it was a little shove there. You see the flag coming in as he made the adjustment and went on upfield on his own.
2:23 left to play, and there is the Rams now coming back to tie the game. Well, it's the Bears. Green Bay's in trouble. A lot of it. Bears having their troubles. 2-4. Mike Thomas breaks the crust. Gets ahead.
Good blocking on the right side of the line then. Good blocking. You see Mike going back and telling the right side of the line what a good job they've done. Stark and Terry Hermeling back in there. Miami leading San Diego now.
Norm
13-7. Boulash on a 3-yard run.
Thomas has now run 56 yards and 16 carries for the Skins. Second and about three, a power run into the right side of the Eagle defense. We'll see if it got there. Had to get the ball out to the 46. 1:30 left to play in the first and the third quarter. Here comes second tight end of the game. Jerry Smith comes back in.
Jerry Smith, but
never that big, but he could always block.
They also brought in Nugent as a. Maybe they're going to make some adjustments here. They're bringing Nugent up as a tight end also. Now, Smith is outside
yeah,
of him.
Right.
Yeah, they put Jerry as a flanker. That's what they've done. Nugent is a tight end.
Penalty marker goes down as Smith cut in and knocked down a linebacker. Right behind him came Clarence Harmon.
Whatever it was, it worked. The play worked.
Got the ball out to midfield. Bob Tucker just joined Fran Tarkin in at Minnesota, just caught a touchdown pass.
It didn't take him long. Minnesota leading Atlanta 14-7 in the fourth quarter with 8:17 remaining.
He must have
what do you think?
Offside 79, defense First down.
Manny Sistrunk was offside. So the Redskins get a first down at midfield. They lead the game 23-10. They led 20-10 at the half. 59 seconds to play now in the third quarter. Heisman times it out to Grant, and a down and out. Quick out. He's knocked down at the 45-yard line of the Eagles. Got five.
Joe's called a smart game today. He's mixed his plays well. Mixed his receivers well. Bugs has caught four. Grant, four. Fugit's caught three for 82 yards. He's also thrown three to Thomas and one to Calvin Hill. So he's mixed his receivers well.
Next week, the Redskins go against the Colts at Baltimore. The Eagles will be back. Then Philadelphia to play New Orleans. Here's Clarence Harmon on a sweep. Drew Mihalik pursuing him and gets him with LeMaster. But he runs the ball down close to the 40. As the third quarter now is winding out. This will be, that was the final play of the third quarter. The Redskins will go into the final 15 minutes with a 13-point lead. There's the gun. That's the end of the third quarter with the score. The Washington Redskins 23, the Philadelphia Eagles 10, and we now pause for a word from your local station.
A half-wild mountain child that's kept under lock and key brings Rafferty onto the scene tomorrow night on CBS.